Hey, you're not answering the radio.
Yep. I know, I was...
Well, hold on.
No, I'm all right. Just... trying to get clear, you know?
You're burning up.
Ugh, my head's pounding like a mother.
You're burning up.
No, I'm just tired.
Okay, stay here, rest. I'll think of something.
Look, I don't need a goddamn babysitter, I'm fine.
Here, come here, I'll show you what you're looking for.
Yep, found it.
All right, come on, focus.
I am focused.
All right, so this one is called Lavandula angustifolia.
Lavender?
Yes, well, I'm still paying off my student loan, so I will stick with Latin, mm-hmm. But you can call it that.
Yeah, get your money's worth, go for it.
Okay, come on, give me your hands. All right, so you want to put one hand around the flower.
All right.
And then put the other hand at the stem.
Okay.
Just like that, and then you pull nice and slow.
Yeah, I pulled weeds before.
Excuse me, sir, this is not a weed. You have to be gentle.
But apply pressure.
Oh, yeah, but not too hard. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Go. There you go, that's perfect.
And it doesn't smell very good.
Okay, you hold on to those, and I'm gonna collect more.
So, why lavender?
Well, the guys at the lab are pretty excited. They think they have this subspecies, which might have mutated monoterpenoids, which produce a modified linalool that...
That is so... Oh, my... Thank you, Einstein. Thank you.
Sorry. It has a chemical that we can use to synthesize a new medicine for burn patients.
Where I'm from, the only weed used for medicine is the kind that you smoke. You know, Boozer knows a guy with a farm that's about 3 miles up the road.
Oh, that's great. Boozer's gonna wind up in prison and take you with him.
So what else do you guys make? Like chemical weapons, WMDs, shit like that?
No. Well, at least not me.
Yeah?
It's in my contract. None of my research can be used for military purposes.
Hey, there's more over here.
Wait, stop.
Oh, come on, the weather's gonna be great.
Hold on.
What's wrong?
Well, I didn't mean stop that.
Come on, what is it?
It's a long story.
Well, that's okay. We can just walk. I like walking.
So, why don't you tell me about your plants?
Really? Okay. Well, this particular genus is adventitious.
You want me to ask?
It means not native to this area. You can thank Ogden for that.
Who? Oh, shit, I asked.
Peter Skeen Ogden, first explorer to come through this part of Oregon. He and some of the other early explorers brought all their medicinal herbs and plants with them. Some got away, and now they're growing here. mostly along the shores of small lakes and ponds.
First white explorer.
Wow, look at you, being all politically correct.
Don't buy into all the biker stereotypes you see on TV. We are actually quite charming.
I bet.
The MC's got a couple of brothers, one fully patched.
I don't think I've seen one person of color since I arrived in your strange little backwater paradise.
Yeah, Jack actually had some guys bust in from Sacramento just to piss off our skinhead rivals.
He did not.
No, he did not. I'm kidding. Jersey Jim's an old buddy of mine. Patched him and myself. We served in the same unit. Come by the clubhouse Sunday. I'll show you around. You'd like the guy. He's funny as shit. He makes a mean margarita.
Well, I have to be in the lab early on Monday, so...
I'll have us back in your bed by 10. I promise.
How can I refuse an offer like that? Okay, you try picking some now.
Lavender. You want me to pick lavender?
Yep. And bring me 3 plants and don't crush them.
Oh, I'm gonna crush them.
Come on.
Got one.
Good for you.
This one?
Yep, keep going.
Last one.
Great, bring them here. Oh.
For you.
Wow, gallantry is alive and feral after all.
Mm. If he's not, then I didn't kill him.
Hey! Aw, poor guys.
Hey, is that the one we're gonna smoke later?
No, but this is the one we're gonna drink. I make this killer herbal tea with it.
I'll bet.
Hey, all right, if you come over, then I will make it for you as long as you give me a ride home.
All right, great.
You're gonna be a believer.
And we'll grab a beer for myself on the way over.
Sorry, a little out of it. Wait, you said something?
It's something Sarah showed me a few summers ago. Or... Anyway, there's a plant that grows out here called lavender. It grows in the shade, along rivers, lake shores. I'm gonna see if I can find some.
Shit, brother. The way my arm's feeling, I'll try anything. But fuck the lavender, bring something I can smoke.
Whatever, I'm gonna find some of this shit. I'm gonna make a burn sap out of it, and you're gonna shut the hell up about it.
Sorry, brother. Just going stir crazy up here, you know?
Don't worry, Booze Man. We're riding north, I swear to God, not too much longer. You hear me?
Yeah, out. Deke, you there? I crafted you a couple of items if you want to swing by.
Yes, yes. Always beautiful shit. Thanks, brother. Deacon out.
whelp!
Hey, Boozer.
God damn it!
It's a funny thing. I was remembering how, a few summers back, Sarah took me out to Bear Creek. We were picking lavender, and, she taught... she taught me how to make this sap for burns, and,
Look, I got out today. Okay? I actually had a look around the mountain. I cleared some traps. The garm's almost as good as new.
All right. Okay. I'm just gonna leave it right here.
Hey, just give me a couple days, okay? Just ride up north like you said and get out of this shithole.
Sure. Yeah.
You there?
Yeah, I'm here. What's up?
We got hit. And hard. Rippers. A couple of dozen, maybe more.
Goddamn rippers.
That little gal you were so worried about?
Yeah, Lisa. Wait, hold on. What happened? Where's Lisa?
Gone. They took her and three others. Alki followed them as far as he could. But they're holed up at Belknap Crater. He came back to round up more men, but...
God damn it! Okay, look, I've seen what those sons of bitches do to hostages. I'm not waiting.
Thank you.
doctor in here.
Free rule the world, huh? Not if they're all dead.
No, she's not in here. Where are you, Lisa?
I can't.
She's gotta be out here somewhere.
It was part of the release. It was part of the. No one is joining you! Now you're found, yeah?
Yes! Run at him!
Hang on, Lisa. No matter what they do to you, just hang on. This way. She's gotta be this way.
Here.
You're lost.
Cover. Cover.
Here, they dragged her up here. Lisa's gotta be up there.
No. There she is.
Lisa. All right, Lisa. Oh, Jesus, what have they done to you? Lisa. Lisa? Hey, sweetheart.
No!
Hey, hey!
No!
Shut up! It's me. It's Deacon. Remember? Deacon? Okay. All right. That's all right. It's all right. Come on. You okay? Do you know where the visitor center is? All right, that's where my bike is. I need you to run there as fast as you can. Don't stop.
Don't stop.
All right, don't stop, no matter what. You ready? Huh? Go.
Lisa,
get down! Run.
We're safe now. Are you okay?
No.
Listen to me. To the south of here, there's a camp at Lost Lake. It's nothing like the hot springs. Iron Mike, he's not like Mrs. Tucker.
I hated Mrs. Tucker.
Well, you wouldn't be alone there. This is a nice camp, and it's a safe place.
Okay.
Hold on.
Ricky! Ricky, come back! Ricky, are you still on this channel? Lost Lake Camp, come in.
Deacon? Ugh, long time no hear. What do you want?
Just meet me, okay? On the Cascade Highway where it intersects with the old Belknap Road. I'm heading there now.
You know what Iron Mike said the night you and Boozer rode out of here?
Yeah. That. Listen, that's why I radioed you and not Schizo. Iron Mike doesn't even have to know about this. I got a kid here.
What?
Well, I mean, not a kid. A survivor. She's been out here a long time.
You've got a survivor, and you're bringing her to Lost Lake.
No, you're bringing her to Lost Lake. I'm bringing her to you. Ricky, you there?
Yeah, okay. I'm on my way. Lost Lake out.
Ricky? Yeah, okay. You're welcome. You're gonna like it there, kid. Like I said, Iron Mike, he likes to yell a lot. Look, don't let him bother you. Got that? Anyway, there's this guy named Schizo. If he bothers you at all, well, just tell Ricky. Or, tell Addie. She's the camp's doctor. You tell her. And she's good. She's got medicine, you know, to clean up those cuts. I mean, you don't want to get infected. They're gonna help you out, kid. You can count on them, even if you, even if you screw up. All right.
Hey, Ricky.
Hey, Deke. I'm surprised. What, did Tucker give up the slave trade?
Lisa, this is, Ricky. She's gonna, take you to a safe place.
Nothing has changed, Deke. Iron Mike is not gonna pay you for this.
Pay me for... Oh, come on. That's not what this is about. It's not about collecting a bounty or anything. You just take her. Huh?
What's wrong with her, Deke?
What's wrong with her? She was... had a run-in with some rippers. I had to...
Oh, my God. Hey, Lisa. Hi, I'm Ricky. Listen, do you like to go fishing? I love fishing. It's my favorite thing in the whole wide world. Would you want to go fishing with me? Yeah? Come on, I'm gonna tell you about Lost Lake. It has the clearest water you have ever seen. And the fish, oh my God. The fish in the morning, they jump this high. I'll show you. When we go, we're gonna have such a good time. Make sure you hold on tight, okay? Ready?
I really appreciate it. That's amazing. Yeah, I do need some. Deacon out.
You there? Hot Springs to Deacon St. John.
Tucker, I'm here.
I expected you back by now. Did you find the girl, Lisa?
No, Tuck, no. The Rippers cut her up pretty bad, and she didn't make it.
God damn it. We needed her. Now the digging's going to get even further behind.
Well, look on the bright side, Tuck. One less mouth to feed, yeah?
You get out there and find me some warm bodies, or there won't be any mouths left to feed. Tucker out.
Okay, I'm gonna get right on that. Should be it.
They're coming. They won't know. I mean, they're on me.
Sugar? Bowser, what's going on?
No! How'd you get in here?
Whoa.
You stay right there!
Bowser, it's me.
Stay there.
It's Deke. Let's just
go.
Don't
come any closer. I will kill you.
It's all right.
Come on, give me the gun. Give me the gun, buddy.
No, I will not!
Oh, shit. Oh, Jesus Christ. Bowser, what the fuck?
I heard him. I heard voices.
Oh, shit.
I mean, you heard him, right?
No, I didn't hear shit, Boozer. You got blood poisoning.
I do not.
Yes, you do, Boozer. Just take a look.
I don't need to take a look.
Come on, we gotta get you some help.
Look, I don't need some.
Come on.
Damn it, I don't need help. Sorry about that. About trying to blow your head off. I mean, no, I thought I saw something, you know?
Easy. Hey, watch the steps.
I got this. I mean, it was in my head, you know?
Yeah, I know.
I could hear him, Deke. I could hear him, Deke. Footsteps pounded in my head. Boots.
Just a few more steps.
I don't need any help. I can goddamn walk. I can walk.
Okay.
I don't know what happened.
Yeah, now come on. Get on, we gotta go.
Wait. What? Where are we going? I don't...
It's just a short ride, Boozer. It'll help clear your head.
Right? Yeah, okay. That'd be good. Yeah, okay. Where are you going? Deke?
You remember when we first rode out of Farewell? What that was like?
Yeah. I remember.
The highways were all choked up with cars. There were so many people, all on the move, thinking of it. If they could only go fast enough, that they'd outrun what was coming.
Yeah.
No one could move fast enough, Boozer. No one saw it coming the way I did. So by the time they said, fuck it, you know, and started walking and then running, it's too late.
Too late.
And I remember watching the freaks. Watching them all come, thousands of them. And all those dumb shits just got swallowed up.
Yeah, I remember.
When you see a thing like that, you know it's only a matter of time. Before it's our turn. Nothing's gonna stop it, Boozer. Not a goddamn thing, but... But do you know why we keep going?
No.
Because what the hell else are we gonna do?
Yeah.
Lately I've been wondering what's been going on. I've been here before, but I don't remember when. And every time we get to where we're entering, I feel my beliefs and hopes surrendering. But I know I'll be coming home soon. Yes, I know I'll be coming home soon. It's like the enemies that we are battling. I am nothing but a human alien. I left with nothing else but to keep wandering down this path while stopping my hands trembling. Because I know that I'll be coming home soon. And yes, I know that I'll be coming home soon. With a soldier's eyes,
with a soldier's eye. With a soldier's eyes. With a soldier's eyes, I've seen inside the devil's dreams where young men die. In graveyards open up their arms for mothers left to cry. I have seen the bleeding and I hear what we've done. But just like every other fool here, I'll keep marching on. Because I know that I'll be coming home soon. With a soldier's eyes. With a soldier's eyes. And yes, I know coming home soon. With a soldier's eyes. With a soldier's eyes.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Figured you'd get all purdied up before heading in.
Well, you know. Yeah, I figured I'd stop in the lodge, have a few beers, and then just stroll into the infirmary. No, I'm just sick of it.
No, I don't care. I'm just fucking with you. Hey, Deke. Mike said he'd kill you if he ever saw you again. And if he said it...
That old man doesn't remember his name half the time.
No.
Hey,
he'll remember.
You gotta stay awake. We're off the open road, but if a freaker wanders back.
Yeah, I know. All right. Hey, Deke.
Yeah.
Don't you kill anyone in the camp, okay?
Not gonna kill anyone. You good?
Never better.